Buds, what's up, man? You left some leaves burning out here.
Yeah, I just came in just for a second.
Come on, man. If it's too hot to touch, it's too hot to leave. You could torch the whole neighborhood.
It's a good point there, Smoke Key.
9 out of 10 wildfires are caused by humans.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Congratulations on taking the gold in badminton today.
Thank you.
Is this your first time competing in the senior games?
No, it's my second. I competed in the 2009. Not in mixed though, just doubles and singles.
And did you place then?
I got silver in the doubles, and I got a ribbon in the singles.
So how does it feel to take the gold this time around?
Oh, it feels great. I was hoping that I could get it, and I did. So that was fun.
What's the key to being successful in badminton? Is there like a certain technique or trick that you're known for or that you'd prefer to do?
I'm probably known best for my trick shots. I don't have a lot of power anymore. So I go for placement and some trick shots. I tend to do that a lot when I play mixed.
Have you been playing for a long time?
Yeah, about 25 years. Yeah, yeah.
Well,
a lot of tournaments in that time period.
Well, we look forward to seeing you more at the senior games this year, and good luck to you.
Thank you.
Cindy, congratulations on taking the gold. Is this your first time at the senior games?
Yes, that's my first time.
And how long have you been playing badminton?
About 11 years. Yeah, that's the first time I've been this one. Then I got silver in the women's single and silver in the women's double.
Well, congratulations to you. How does it feel your first time out at the senior games to be so successful?
I'm very excited, and fortunately, I have a good partner, that's George. And we have been playing several tournaments before, and he taught me a lot. So that's a key point, that just keep calm and do whatever we supposed to do.
Receiving the bronze medal, Deborah Lorenzo. And your gold medalist, Carolyn Hoffer.
So tell us, how does it feel to be competing in the senior games this year?
It's been a wonderful experience. This is my first time ever in Cleveland, Ohio. And I really loved the organization of this event. And most especially, I had the opportunity to meet my friends again. We don't see each other. It's every two-year event, so it's really been great, and we always have a blast when we see each other.
Yeah. Aside from the National Senior Games, have you been competing in badminton for a long time in other organizations?
Yes, right here in the U.S. I started my first nationals in Louisville, Kentucky, and ever since then I have been attending every nationals every 2 years. So I have done Louisville, Kentucky, Palo Alto, Houston, and these games here.
Do you only compete in badminton, or do you compete in other sports as well?
In the past, I used to compete in table tennis as well, but I decided to give it up because sometimes the times are conflicting with badminton. So I decided to give it up for my most beloved sport.
And congratulations to you, double winner so far today.
Yeah.
How does it feel?
Oh, I feel excellent.
Is this your first National Senior Games?
No, this is my second time.
And how many times have you medaled?
Twice. This is my twice. Second time.
But in the past you haven't?
Yeah. I don't know.
Okay. So what makes you love badminton so much?
I don't know. I don't know how to say.
It's okay.
I love badminton, and this is my hobby, my favorites. Yeah.
What do you think of Cleveland so far?
Nice city. I love it. The people very nice. And the food's good, and the people's great, and organized very nice. Excellent. I love it.
All right, George, I have not held a badminton racket since I was like 10. So can you please reteach me how to even do badminton?
Sure. Okay, when you hold it, this is the grip, and you want to hold it so that if you see this edge down here,
mm-hmm.
this edge should fit in the gap between your thumb and your first finger.
Okay.
So that's the grip. A lot of people hold it this way. This is called the pancake grip. There isn't a lot of power in it, but some women use it at the net so they can just hit it down like that.
Okay.
If you want the power, you have to hold it this way because the power comes from the rotating the forearm like that. That's a forehand, it's a backhand.
Okay, let me try. So I'll switch.
Okay.
You hold this and describe if I'm doing it right or wrong. Okay, so the power is in like this. I'm going to grip it.
That's wrong.
This is wrong? Okay.
Okay, remember, okay, here's the line. Here's the line,
mm-hmm.
and that line has to go down between your thumb and your, no. We're gonna be here for another day or rotate it, right. Actually, it's a lot like shaking hands. So if you're shaking hands, that's the grip.
Oh.
So shake hands with the racket. Say hello, Mr. Racket. No. Do you shake hands like that with your thumb up there? Shake hands there. Okay. So you want to have
like
the
this.
Thumb, right, except that you want to curve it up like that. More.
Got it. No,
okay.
Not really.
Okay, close enough.
Okay.
There, yeah, curl it around.
Okay.
Okay. And this forefinger can be up a little bit, up here.
This one?
Right.
I feel it all in my arm here.
Right. You don't want to have a tight grip on it. It's not like you're holding a hammer.
Oh, okay. Right.
It's more like, think of it as like a bird. You're holding a bird in your hand. You want to have a fairly loose grip until you actually do the power stroke. But you want to have a loose grip so that you can be flexible on.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So that way you can move the racket head around and you can hit the bird different positions. So that's
like,
the wrist work.
So like this?
No. You don't want to have this making contact with your right. This needs to be down there, right. So that way you can rotate.
Oh.
Right.
Okay. Right. So that's the key to hitting the birdie.
And when you go in, you can go in like this. And you for forehand, you want to roll it like this. This is when you're at the net. Roll the bird up like this, so the bird goes over the net like that. On the backhand, you want to sort of cut the bird like that, and that tumbles it over the net. So that's how you do the net shots.
This is how a gold medalist does the net shots. I'm learning from the expert right here. So just like this.
Well, right. When you cut it, you want to just cut it like that. This shot is for like a cross court,
okay.
Right? So you're going like that to fake out the opponent. You just tell your opponent you're going to put it right there, and then you roll the wrist and go across.
Oh.
That's the backhand cross.
Like that.
Yeah.
Not too shabby
for being
a practically newbie again.
And it's easier when you don't have a bird to hit.
Right? Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it.